What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and today we'll continue our archery game with Xbox controller inputs. We'll continue our movement script to move the archer around with a joystick, we'll create custom inputs via Unity's input manager, and also talk about best practices. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin! Let's talk about virtual inputs a bit. Let's say we access the inputs in scripts directly, like input.getKey_R or input.getKey_joystick_button_0. However, when we need to change, say, the firing action from key R to Q, then we have to find and modify all the occurrences in scripts where we use input.getKey_R. If we use virtual inputs, we can simplify any key binding changes without the need to touch the scripts. We can define virtual inputs in Unity's input manager by naming them, for example, move horizontal or fire, and binding them to native inputs like the R key or joystick button too. Then we can access the virtual inputs from code like input.getAxis move horizontal or input.getButton fire. In case we need to change an actions key, we can just modify its virtual input's native input in the input manager. Let's create our virtual inputs. We need to open up Unity and go to Edit, Project Settings, Input. Then in the Inspector window, we can see all the default virtual inputs or axes that Unity has already defined for us. We used a few of these in previous videos, but now we are creating our own. Axis is a list, so to add new inputs to it, we have to increment its size. Incrementing it by 1, we can see the new input appearing at the bottom of the list. Let's name it Move Horizontal and remove everything in the bottom fields. This input will be joystick based, so we don't need them. It doesn't change much, but let's set its gravity to 1. It only affects buttons and not sticks. A joystick's inputs are values between minus 1 and 1 with a neutral value of 0 if it's resting in the middle. Dead is the dead zone's size, which is a threshold value of the stick to ignore everything below that. Let's set this to 0.2, which means if the joystick's input is between minus 0.2 and 0.2, then Unity will handle them as 0 to compensate worn down controllers or different manufacturers. Let's set sensitivity to 1. Other values will multiply the input value, but the highest value always stays at 1. For example, sensitivity set to 2 will give you an input value of 1 and not 0.5 when you push the stick halfway to the right. Let's set type to joystick axis, axis to X axis, and we are done. Let's increment axis's size again by 1. Change the name to move vertical and set axis to Y axis, and that's it. We have our custom virtual input to handle joystick movement. But let's create another one for firing. Increment the size one last time, name it fire, and set its positive button to joystick button 0 on Windows or joystick button 1 on Mac. We need to set its gravity and sensitivity to 1000 and dead to 0.001 to trigger instantly. Now we can access this from code as well. If you want to use different sticks or buttons, then Google search for Unity controller mapping and see the images or experiment with the inputs until you find the one you need. Let's open up our previous script and replace horizontal to move horizontal and vertical to move vertical. Now, if we test it, then the vertical movement is inverted. We need to go back to Edit, Project Settings, Input, and under Move Vertical, we have to check Invert. That's much better. To show you that the fire virtual input is working, I make an if statement to check if the joystick's button is pressed and print out the fire message if it is. Now we can move around and, in theory, fire. Fantastic! As you could see, different operating systems may have different key mappings, but different controllers may have different ones also. It's a big task to make your game have good controller support. If you want to publish games commercially, then I highly recommend buying a Unity asset for that in the store, like in Control or Rewired. I wanted to show you how to use controller inputs for free, but in the future I will be using Rewired, which is a paid asset. Trust me, it will save you a lot of time on input handling, and it will let you focus on your game. That's it for today, folks. Saturday, we will continue with a 2D freeform directional blend tree to make animation transitions between running and walking. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions from today, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!